Hi, I am Shuresh Ghimire, Assistant Extension Educator at UConn Extension. Mulching is an integral part of the vegetable production systems. Plastic mulching is being widely used for controlling weeds, conserving soil moisture, and for several other benefits that lead to increased crop production and quality. Currently, very poorly biodegradable polyethylene mulch is very widely used, and it needs to be removed and disposed at the end of every cropping season, and that is environmentally and economically costly. Plastic mulch, when it fragments in the soil, it forms microplastics. This is an emerging threat to agroecosystems. Biodegradable plastic molds are an alternative to regular plastic molds, and as they provide similar crop production benefit to regular plastic molds, but also can be tilled into the soil at the end of the season, they provide added benefits. Farmers and researchers are investigating and using biodegradable plastic molds in their operation.
Hi, I'm Bruce Jr. from Gresczyk Farms in New Hartford, Connecticut. We grow about 130 acres of vegetables, and we use a lot of plastic mulch. And in the past couple years, we've made the switch to using biodegradable plastic mulch. In particular, we are currently using Bio360. It's a brand of biodegradable plastic mulch. For us, the benefit has been that we don't have to pick up the plastic at the end of the season, which is a lot of labor, and we also don't have to pay to bring it to a landfill. And there's also the environmental side, which doesn't particularly save us money directly, but it helps us all as we go along. It's found to be very effective. We tried it initially 3 years ago in a very small basis, and then we found every year we increased it a little bit, and we've been very happy with its results, whereas this year we were 100% all biodegradable plastic mulch in everything we did. There's only a few exceptions for like long-term crops like garlic, which would be overwintering, or strawberries, which we grow on plastic, which might need to last for a full year, where we've been a little hesitant to try it, but we're going to start experimenting, doing one row at a shot, just to make sure to see if they were missing out on something or not.
What's the profitability using biodegradable plastic versus conventional plastic?
A straight up cost from plastic to plastic, it's almost double the cost of the traditional plastic. But when you actually measure it out, one roll is typically around 4,000 feet of plastic, and the time it took us to pick that up at the end of the growing season, particularly in a challenging crop where you might have a lot of holes poked in it, the labor savings alone was kind of a wash, made it so it was about even. And then you just don't have to spend the time, which time is always a crunch in this business. So particularly in the fall, like right now, it's the end of September, and we're still harvesting all the summer crops. We're trying to harvest winter crops, and we don't have the time to be able to do the proper cleanup of picking up plastic at the end of every crop. Whereas now all we have to do is, you know, dispose of like the field behind us. We have to pull the tomato stakes, pull out the tomato string. And normally we would then have to go mow the tomatoes, then lift the plastic, then pull the plastic up, bring it to a landfill, pay to have it done in a landfill, and it's quite the labor, whereas now we just have to clean up the stuff that we can't leave in the field, and then we get to till it in.
Are you concerned about plastic mulch fragments flying around?
Originally we were, that's why we tried it on a very small basis, since then, we haven't really had any issue with that, so we've been expanding it, and that's why we've gone to 100% production, because we haven't had any issues yet. In the past, there'd always be seasons where we wouldn't get to pick up the plastic mulch because it was wet or because the crop was ran too long into the end of the season, and we used to have plastic that would then, the regular plastic would then fly in, up in the air, and that was always more of a problem than I ever imagined the biodegradable one being. The only crop we experienced mulch adhesion on was our cantaloupe, where the netting made it a little hard to wipe it off. In the cases of like watermelon, which is another crop that we grow that sits on the plastic, that one was, well, there was a little bit on some of it when you picked it up. It wasn't really any more than just wiping off the dirt that we would normally wipe off from normally harvesting it. But with the cantaloupe, it was a little more stuck to it, to say the least. And so that was probably the only crop I found yet that we really had a concern with. And from my just quick watching it, because we used biodegradable on our onions and everything, there was no trouble on that. And I had a concern with it on them. But I was surprised to see there was no real adhesion to it. I think it's just crops that are sitting there on top of the plastic completely like a cantaloupe for a long time while that thing sizes up. That would seem to be the real issue.
Thank you, Bruce, for your time.
Anytime for UConn Extension. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.